Yes, I know, I've already made a video about noise reduction, more specifically about why back then, when I made that video, I was almost never using it, because I was mainly using cameras that have built-in noise reduction, like my Sony a7S III for example. But a few weeks ago, I was trying out the Pixyz 12K, which shoots RAW, and so it doesn't have built-in noise reduction. I had to apply noise reduction myself in DaVinci Resolve 20. And I was just amazed by how good it is. So let me show you just how good and easy to apply it is, so that you can get perfect results. Minimum noise, maximum detail. Because that's what noise reduction is all about. So in the color page, first find the noise reduction effect and drop it on a node. Simple. And then you'll see that here you get the two main types of noise reduction. Temporal and spatial. Let's start with temporal noise reduction. So the idea here is that you can set the amount of frames Resolve will look at before and after the frame that you're on. And based on the information it gets, the changes between those frames, it will apply noise reduction. Now you can go all the way up to 5 frames, but the problem is that the higher you go, the more difficult it is for your computer. But the difference between, let's say, 3 and 5 is usually not that big, not that significant. So personally, I always set it to 3 or lower. And then type here, you can set to faster or better. The best option, of course, is always better because it will give you the best result. Duh. And then motion range, well, it depends on the amount of motion in your shot. So in this case, when I play the clip, the camera moves just a little bit and there's some slow moving subjects with almost no motion blur, so I can just leave it at small. But if there's more movement in your shot, you have to bump it up. Okay, and then always check this box, split luma and chroma. And this is super important because, like I've shown you many times before in other videos, there are two types of noise. Luma noise, which is colorless. It almost looks like film grain. And then there's also chroma noise or colored noise. And that's the noise that causes these blotchy green and magenta artifacts. You can see it here in the shadow on this small car. See? That's chroma noise. That's the bad noise. And it's always bad because it always looks ugly. Chroma noise. And then the luma noise, well, that's subjective. I don't mind it that much, but I mean, if you want a super clean image, that's fine. But that's why you should always split the chroma and luma noise sliders. So you can reduce both types of noise separately and to your liking. And look, you'll see it right away when I use the chroma slider. It will get rid or at least minimize those ugly magenta and green, yeah, blotchy areas. But you'll still see luma noise, you know, the one that looks like film grain, colorless. See? And if you want to get rid of that, you have to use the luma noise slider. But here's the thing, where the chroma slider reduces mostly noise, the luma slider will also reduce detail in your image. Look, when you look at the text on the sign here, see, when I reduce chroma noise, it almost doesn't affect the sharpness. When I reduce luma noise, the text gets a bit softer, so we're losing detail. And that's exactly what noise reduction is all about. Reducing the noise as much as possible without losing too much detail and texture. And then the motion slider defines the threshold separating which moving pixels are in motion versus which moving pixels are static. So it's connected to the motion range setting here. And you use it to avoid unwanted artifacts when there's movement and motion blur. And blend? Well, yeah, you can use it to blend the effect. Set it to 0 or to 100%. But 100 is 0% and 0 is 100%. To make it a bit more complicated. Okay, so that was temporal noise reduction. Now let's move on to spatial noise reduction, which is more powerful, but it also, you know, eats GPUs for breakfast. Yeah, anyway. So first the mode, always use at least better, but the enhanced mode is even better than better because it will preserve much more detail and texture. But of course, again, it will make your computer suffer even more. And I'll show you ultra in a bit. And then we have again the luma and chroma sliders. And then the radius slider here you use to reduce unwanted artifacts and aliasing. So softening caused by the noise reduction in areas with lots of detail. Now on what you should set this depends. According to the manual, the more noise reduction you apply with these sliders, the higher you should set it. But again, the higher you set it, the more your computer will hate you. And then finally, there is this setting here, ultra noise reduction. And this is an AI-based noise reduction option. So when you select it and hit analyze, also make sure that show the patch here is checked. And then you'll see this square and you can make it bigger or smaller or turn it into a rectangle. But the idea is that Resolve will use that area within the rectangle or square to automatically apply noise reduction to the image. So it will analyze the noise in that area and then automatically adjust the settings here. See? And it actually works really, really well. But you know, noise reduction is no exact science, and I also don't know how much noise is acceptable for you, for example. So should you use temporal or spatial noise reduction? Well, ideally, you combine a bit of both so that you can get exactly the result that you want. And it takes a bit of practice, also because settings you use on one image will probably not work on another image. So yeah, practice, practice, practice. That's all I can say. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next one.